In a world of political correctness, it's not uncommon for people to tend to tell others what they perceive they would want to hear. For this is necessary in order to win favor. But in contrast, in the realm of religion, and in particular Christianity, the opposite must more frequently be done. In that being true to Jesus Christ often involves telling people what they may not want to hear. And there is always a cost to that sort of integrity, because it often means criticism and rejection as the consequence. Yet in the face of this unpleasant possibility, the gospel counsels us to have courage. Indeed, Jesus advises us not to fear those who can kill the body, but not the soul. Jesus knew that it would not be easy for us, his followers, after his death and resurrection, because it certainly hadn't been easy for him in his short lifetime. In his attempt to reveal all that his Father had asked him to reveal, Jesus faced constant opposition. Yet even in the face of this, he did not switch tactics or change the story in order to please others or make what he was saying more palatable to them. Rather, he kept to the task. He persevered in proclaiming the truth, even though for him the consequences ended up to be quite deadly. We are also reminded that his apostles were very much afraid to do what they knew he was asking them to do until they received the strength of the Holy Spirit, who emboldened them to go out and preach the gospel to every known nation of the day. And like Jesus before them, all except one of them would lose their life to a martyr's death in the process. So in the light of all of this, what is expected of us? Aren't we also supposed to be proclaiming our faith in Jesus Christ and in whatever way we can be preaching his gospel? Of course we are. Are we afraid? Probably a bit, and rightly so. Indeed, if we are not afraid of actually losing our lives for the faith, then rightly so, we may be afraid of losing our social standing with others. We don't want to be considered religious fanatics. We don't want to make people feel uncomfortable in our presence. So we tend to be reticent about acknowledging our religious convictions before others, especially if we are unfamiliar with theirs. We really do believe in Jesus. We believe in his saving work, but even more so from our own experience, we know that it's often rather contentious, and potentially even more than discussing politics, it's so as we discuss religion. But the words of Jesus from the gospel today have to haunt us. Be not afraid, for we know what he means. He is expecting that we will not hesitate to acknowledge our identity as his disciples whenever the opportunity to do so presents itself. He asks that we have the courage of our own Christian convictions, and that we would apply these in every and any matter to which they are relevant. Not to be fanatics, but to be people who are obviously fully formed and motivated by our faith. Surely we can expect some criticism and much discomfort perhaps in the process. But in the end, isn't that a small price to pay against the day that Jesus will acknowledge us as he promises before his Father, because we had the courage not to deny him before others while on earth?